Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, John Richardson, Richard Iolotti, Claudia Winkleman, Rob Beckett, John B., Susie Bates, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, 100 million is the number of M&Ms that are consumed every day in America? And looking at Americans, I think that's per person. Although in Britain we use a decimal point, in much of Europe they use a comma. They are wrong and we are right. Full stop. And 72 is the average number of days women will spend shaving their legs in a lifetime. I bet they're jealous of men like John Richardson who aren't able to grow hair anywhere on their bodies. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up is John Richardson. Sure. John once performed a gig at a hospital, I presume, because they'd run out of anaesthetic. And John's teammate, it's Claudia Winkleman. I'm not saying Claudia looks like a panda, but I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Edinburgh Zoo for lending her to us for the evening. Up against them this evening, it's a special guest team captain, Richard Iolotti. Oh, yeah.
Go on.
Richard Iolotti combines a geeky personality with a brilliant sense of humour. You know, just like John Richardson doesn't. Joining Richard tonight is Rob Beckett. Rob was at the front of the queue when they were handing out teeth. Unfortunately, it was the queue for horses. Rob's wife gave birth to their first child late last year. Great news for everyone, apart from the Tooth Fairy, who's facing bankruptcy. Okay, Richard, do you think you can make a good team captain? Have you got leadership qualities?
I don't know. What's my responsibilities? Do I get a pension? What's the situation?
You've got to sort of manage Rob, I suppose, yeah. Motivate him.
I bought some sweets. I'm sorry, that's a floss stick. You know, you can
drumstick.
Drumstick or...
Or lollipop. Do I get it now or do I have to do well?
At the end of the quiz. Depending on the performance.
To be fair, I'm trying to stay away from them because if I don't keep my teeth in good nick, I don't really have any jokes.
Oh, please.
Richard, are you a fan of Countdown? I mean, you look as if you'd be a fan.
That's very prejudicial. What does a Countdown fan look like? That gloriously broad demographic.
You look like you'd play this game because you've got glasses on, that tie, and just you're not sitting back in your chair. You're too eager to sit down and write. It's like that. Just relax your shoulders.
I am relaxed. Don't
you're
touch
not relaxed.
Me. don't get just I am your captain.
Who'd have thought that 5 minutes into this show I'd be thinking, do you know what? Sean is a real people person.
Rob, obviously your captain is eloquent and intelligent. How do you think you're going to sort of mix with that?
Well, obviously, we're very different, aren't we?
I wouldn't say that.
Yes, I would. You go in charge of spelling the numbers and I'll deal with all social interaction. I think that's probably us batting at the best.
No one told me there would be social interaction or I would not have come.
Well, this may be the worst team we've ever put together. We're getting nowhere. John, what else are you working on at the moment?
Well, I've been working on a few products actually, aside from comedy, in case that goes tits up. I've bought the software that works autocorrect, and I've managed to turn it into pill form, so you swallow it and it corrects speech before it's even left your mouth. So, like, it corrects things like could have to could have. I can't be there to correct everyone all the time, that's what I've learnt. My wife, I've sort of chipped away at her and her errors. She's making good progress, but she's resistant to change, if I'm honest, Jimmy. All I knew about women is what... Cos I'd never encountered many before. I only knew what I'd seen on adverts. So sometimes I say, oh, it's a nice sunny day, why don't we go to the park and you can eat a yoghurt on a bench? Not really into that. And the rollerblades I got for the days when she's on her special time, they've... they've gone untouched. But, you know, you live and learn.
Claudia, are you happy being on John's team?
Yeah, I'm so... But I love this. This is my favourite team.
Oh, don't patronise us. We're in hell.
We're going to be all right.
Yeah, be... Oh, of course
I think he's a bit worried about... It's his first time on it. He's a bit panicked because there's people here. Right. I think eventually we'll get on board together and we'll unite and it'll be great.
Right. If you love me, I'll flourish.
Okay. How can I love you without touching
that?
You? What if I just talk to you softly in your ear, like nice things?
Just say...
Just come here and I'll just say nice things. I won't touch her.
Yeah?
Okay. No, well, I've not said anything yet.
It's just that was just like sonar. I just knew something was getting close.
I like your glasses.
Thank you.
So, in answer to your question, yeah, I'm really happy.
John, have you got a mascot this evening? What have you brought?
Yes, I have, Jimmy. Yes, we've done a few of these now, haven't we, Jimmy?
We've done a few, yeah.
What happens is people relax and the rules start getting disobeyed. And we all know you can't have fun without rules. So I've invited someone along to help keep the rules this evening. So please welcome former Premier League referee Dermot Gallagher. Dermot will be summoned when I blow my whistle. Any impingement of the rules.
Right.
So any bad language will be punishable. Sexual touching will be...
But what about just touching?
That will be down to my judgment, and I am a sexual expert. Three times now. And I won all three. So,
you mean you came first?
So, Dermot is on hand, and he will come in. Thank you, Dermot.
Excellent. Dermot, everyone. You're our referee. Claudia, have you got a mascot?
I do. I thought that it would be helpful for us to eat. And I like Christmas, so I have got a Christmas cake and decorations.
Okay.
And we're going to make a Christmas cake because you can never start too soon. We've got all of this. Me and John are going to have a lovely time.
What's that, fake tan?
No.
Are you eating the icing just straight out of the tube?
Going to be excellent, and then at the end we'll all eat it.
Yeah. Okay, Claudia's cake, everyone. Fun. Okay. Richard, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I've got a few. So I've got my lucky thesaurus that I just as I've been through thick and thin with that one, and my lucky calculator. So those are there. Those two. Lucky objects. The last thing
what
have
you got?
Is this fellow, Tony. I'll just pop there.
Who is Tony?
Tony's a guy I met in in the Emirates, and we really connected, and so we've lost touch. So yeah, it's basically if Tony watches this, even if it's on YouTube, just get in touch. I thought we had something. We did have something. I didn't think it. I know we did.
Rob, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I've got a mascot. Basically, obviously, I'm not the best at spelling or numbers. And also, when I was younger, I struggled with my homework a little bit. And to build my confidence up doing my homework, my mum used to give me squash and biscuits and say nice things to me. So what I've done is I've got some squash and biscuits and I've got some of the nice things she used to say to me written on them and things that I liked growing up, like flubber. It's one of my favourite films, so when I'm struggling with the words, I can just look at that and go, oh, I liked that film, didn't I? And then other stuff, like, it could be worse, you could have no teeth. Your dad was not the star of Jaws, things... And just little bits and bobs, you know. Remember, Rob, some of them are laughing with you. Do you want a biscuit or some squash?
Yeah.
Yeah, like one. What flavour?
Orange or red?
Red.
The problem is I'm really struggling with double concentrate, really. I just can't get the levels right.
I think the trick is just to halve it.
See, that is like...
There
we go, Susan. OK. And making his debut in Dictionary Corner this week, a true legend of the silver screen, Sean Bean.
Good evening, bastards. Actor, father and slayer of dialogue. I've made over 700 films, six of which are good.
I see you've come dressed for the occasion.
No, I'm come dressed for anything. This is what I look like naked.
Are you a fan of word games, Sean?
I'm a fan of catapulting virgins and slaughtering me firstborn, if that's what you mean.
But you know what to do. You've seen Countdown, right?
Yeah, I've seen many a Countdown before, my friend. To a siege, to a coup, to a sachet of Ultra Simple in me microwave oven.
Have you met Susie?
Lady Susie of House Dent and I share a common past. Many moons ago, I told her she had lips like two bouncy castles that I wished to enter with shoes on.
Have you brought in a mascot today, Sean?
No, I've not brought in a mascot, Jimmy, because I'm not fucking six.
Okay. And with Sean, of course, it's Susie Dent. Susie's written 13 books, presented numerous TV shows and edited the dictionary. Impressive stuff. But just imagine how much more she could have achieved if she hadn't spent quite so much time chasing cock. Any new words for 2016 that have caught your eye?
Well, if you ever think that lexicographers don't have a sense of humour, which I know you do, Oxford, on April Fool's Day, published a whole lot of words that they said had just gone into the dictionary. And they were brilliant. One of them was just for you, which is not YOLO, but lo-yo, laughing on your own. That's what you do. I like that. There's also mukbang, which is a real word.
Oh, that's yeah, no. Going in.
That's watching people eat on videos.
That's a verb, mukbang?
It's a verb, yeah.
Verb.
Yeah, but it's not in yet.
OK. Yeah. Will you text me when it
OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel Riley is a mathematician, TV host and physicist. Is there anything she can't do? Yes. Move her feet in time with a piece of music. So, Rachel, Rob has struggled with the numbers on the show before. Any tips for him? Anything he could improve?
Well, I've been thinking about this, actually, and I think...
You've been thinking about this?
Yeah. Well, just tips on math. And I think tips to be better at the numbers game, similar tips to be better at sex.
Oh.
First of all, once you've got your target in sight, you don't want to just dive in and, you know, shoot in the dark willy-nilly. Because basically you'll just end up spending 30 seconds flapping about. You might think it's a long time, but it's not. Anyone will tell you that. But you still need to spend the first few seconds thinking of a plan of action.
Okay,
getting a feel for it.
Plan what you're doing and get a feel for it. Don't just dive in.
And then basically just get the big one and get as close as you can.
I don't know what we're talking about, but I enjoyed that. Thank you very much.
Okay, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Foot Spa.
Richard, we could go to a spa day together. Would that help us bond, do you think? Do you like a spa?
And what would we do in the spa?
Just relax, get a massage, sauna. Do you like being hot?
What, like warm?
Yeah. Hot.
Hot. I'm just looking at the teeth.
OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Richard and Rob, you get the first pick of the letters.
Yes. Two of the C's, two of the V's.
G, Z, E, I.
Vowel.
O.
OK, consonant.
L.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
D.
Vowel.
And A.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
Thank you.
That's easier than it looks. Richard, how many did you get?
I got, well, in total, 7, but it was made out of 2 words.
OK, what's the highest? What's the biggest word?
It's not great, is it, mate?
Well, what do you think the biggest word is?
Either a 4 or a 3.
It's either one of those.
OK, Rob, what have you got?
I think I've got a 6, yeah. But it might not be a word.
OK. Claudia, what have you got?
I've got 2 6s.
OK, John?
Well, I got distracted, so I just...
What by? Oh, is that extra time?
I got 7.
OK, so let's hear your 3 or 4, Richard.
Well, together, a zit goal. As in, to head towards a zit. Is it in there?
Zit's in there. Mm. Goal's in there.
OK. You probably didn't need to look those ones up.
Rob, what was your 6?
Toiled.
And you don't know whether that's a word
I
or
don't
not.
Know what it means, but I've seen it knocking about in letters.
OK, Claudia, your 6?
Detail.
John, what was your 7?
Gloated.
Oh, wow. Excellent.
Oh, look how smug he is.
I know. I'm so pleased with you.
7 points to John and Claudia. No, you don't get a point. Sean Bean, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
Just another 7, Gadisha, which is a flower.
OK, so at the end of that, John and Claudia are in the lead with 7 points. OK, on to our first numbers round. John and Claudia, your turn to pick the numbers.
2 big, please.
2 big.
And 4 small.
OK, wow. We've got 5, 9, 3...
Good game so far.
7, and 50 and 25. And the target, 905.
And your time starts now. So the target was 905. Did you get it, John?
906.
Did you?
Yeah.
Claudia, amazed by that.
I put them all together in a hotchpotch and came out with 575.
Oh, very close. Well done.
How did you do that?
Richard?
21.
21?
Yeah. I just timed the 7 by the 3.
Rob, how'd you do?
Well, I took Rachel's advice and tried to have a plan of action. So I wrote down 905 and was going to work backwards, and it didn't go beyond writing down 905. So I've got 905, but no working out.
OK. John, how'd you get 906?
25 plus 50 is 75.
Yep.
And 7 plus 5 is 12.
Yep.
And multiply those.
900.
And then 9 minus 3 is 6.
Yep, and you won away.
7 points to you.
Amazing.
Rachel, could it be done?
Yes, you could have said 25 minus 7 is 18, times 50 is 900, and add the 5.
Oh.
Okay. OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner now. Sean, how are you feeling? Are you enjoying yourself?
No, I take no enjoyment from this.
What do you do to relax, then?
A kill. A hunt. Watch documentaries like Clash of Clans.
Well, I can't tell you how cool it is to have you. I'm one of your biggest fans.
Oh, yeah? Prove it. What's your favourite me film?
The one set in the past.
Which one?
The one with the sword.
Which one?
The one you're covered in mud.
Which one?
The one where you disobey an order.
Which one?
You've got, like, dank hair.
Which one?
You've got betrayed.
Which one?
You swore vengeance on a priest.
Which one?
You stared at the horizon till it blinked.
Which one?
Where you say, a plague, sir, and then you spit.
Which one?
You belittle the donkey.
Which one?
Where you ogle a wench.
Which one?
You eat half a wagon.
Which one?
It's the one you smile for like 1 second.
Troy. Yeah. No. It's a great film. I play a wily Greek general in it, Odysseus. Sean Odysseus. I gave him a first name. Do you want to hear me Greek accent?
Sure.
You just have.
Sure be, everyone. The scores for the moment, Richard and Rob have no points, John and Claudia have 14. And here is your teaser. The words are meat ride. The clue is it's all about the girth. That's meat ride. It's all about the girth. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were meat ride. The clue was it's all about the girth. It was, of course, diameter. OK, John and Claudia are in the lead. Now, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for John and Richard. So, finally, the battle of the geeks. Richard, your turn to choose the letters.
Before we go any further, Jimmy, we've got a sort of lead to protect, and I'm slightly anxious. There's been a few glances over, and I'm slightly worried that there's going to be some copying going on in this round. I just want to make sure that there's a line that cannot be crossed, so...
Did you put that there to enforce...
This is a barrier over which you may not
some
cross.
Space?
Yes.
Because you would have been fine.
Yeah. I'll be honest, this whole ruse was so I could see the spray close up, because I think it's a bit late for me to get in the Premier League.
What's this about? I don't understand this.
Footballers who somehow cannot be trusted in a marriage somehow obey a phone. I don't know what it is.
OK, now, Richard, John, it's you two going head-to-head now. Okay. Richard, you've got to pick some letters.
Oh, consonant, that
consonant?
One.
Is,
they're good? Yeah.
N.
Great. Another one like that.
S.
Oh, wow. another one. They're addictive.
D.
D. Go on. Keep going.
Another
consonants.
One?
They're just fantastic.
B.
Go on. A vowel.
U.
Okay, consonant.
M. Ooh.
Okay, two more vowels.
O and A.
And would you recommend another vowel, or would you do a consonant? What would you
I'd
do?
I'd go consonant, personally.
Okay, fine, sure.
S.
Okay, yeah. And your time starts now. Richard, what have you got?
I've got a hard four and a possible five.
Well, what are you going to go for, the hard four or the possible
I'm
five?
I'm going for the possible five.
John, how many did you get?
Seven.
Oh!
Oh.
Enough with it.
You really enjoyed that seven.
That's so Sydney. Good!
Richard, what's the five?
Da bums.
Da bums?
Yeah. You know, like, Mrs. Brown, the movie.
Yeah.
It's if you see a whole lot of bums in a, I don't know, maybe you're in a sauna, whatever. Look at the bums on those. Or if you're at a Westlife concert, something like that. Look at the bums on them. Susie, check it. The bums. The bums. Check it.
So the bums not in, sadly. The dars, the coits, lots of things, but not the bums.
I don't want to rush anyone on this bit, but it is quite hot in here.
You say this like we've put you in it, Jimmy.
John, what's your seven?
Abound.
Oh.
Oh.
Abound. Abound. So 7 points to John. Could they have done any better though, Susie?
Sure. It was a six.
Yeah.
Dumbos.
Dumbos.
Sequel to Dumbo. And seven damsons.
So 7 points to John. Oh. Jesus, that's hot. OK, at the end of that, Richard and Rob have no points. John and Claudia have 21. Yeah. Right, now time for Rob and Claudia to go head-to-head. Claudia, your turn to pick the numbers.
I've got a sweet.
Why did you get a sweet? I thought you were getting
my team captains. We're bonding, aren't we? I mean, Richard's given me a sweet.
I said he can have one now and one at the end.
Don't tell me you can't get through that with your teeth.
All right, one large one and the other one's all even, if you can.
What if the target is odd?
We're never going to get it. Let's just get the numbers up and get on with it.
Two, four.
Six.
Yes!
Shut up!
Another six. Oh. Shut up! Eight. Are you happy with 100?
Oh, yes, please.
Lovely.
Only if the answer is 800. What is that?
62.
OK, oh. And your time starts now. The target was 162. Rob, did you get it?
I got 162.
OK, well, Claudia, let's hear how you did it.
6 times 6, 36.
Yeah.
Take that away from 2 times 100.
2 times 100.
It's 200. Take away 36.
164.
164. Oh. Can I not use the 2 again?
You've got an 8 and a 4 left over.
I've got what?
8 and a 4 left over.
You need to...
Unlucky, Claudia. Oh. Never mind.
OK, fine.
Move on, mate.
Divide 8 into 4. 2.
No, you can't stop making it up now.
162!
Rob, how did you do it?
Got the 100. And then I got the 6 and the 2, put them together, 162. I've used all the numbers on the board, got 162.
Have a biscuit.
10 points for Claudia. OK, so Richard and Rob have no points, John and Claudia have 31. Time to go across now to Victory Corner. Sean Bean, what have you got for us this time?
A couple of things, really. I brought along some local produce for everybody. I brought in some cud. chow down on here. Oh. Get that down here.
Oh, I had no idea you were this keen on gardening.
Oh, I'm not. That's shaved straight off me back. I'm 90% bracken. North of the wall, anyway. People often say to me, Sean, what does it feel like to take shit way too seriously? To believe yourself to be an actual medieval warlord and to have challenged the entire city of Wigan to a duel? To that I reply, I cannot feel. I'm a Yorkshireman. My nerves are made of actual steel. I wasn't born, I was smelted. But enough about me. Let's talk about me and my skills as an actor. And I'm widely considered to be one of Britain's muddiest actors. I played a man with a sword, a man with a gun, and a man with a sword who wished he had a gun. And Sean Bean talks. People don't just listen, they shit themselves. Why? Because I'm compelling. How? Because I speak accompanied by this. Lady Susie, if you wouldn't mind holding it for me. I take this highly unstable, untested, unearthed piece of electrical craftsmanship and aim it right at me face. And on my command, unleash hell. Director, I'm going to need a split screen where bottom half is letters and top half is a close-up of me looking fit. That'll do. Right, watch as I give a performance here that could only really be described as straight to DVD. Punch it, Dent. Let's make a word. Consonant.
B.
Vowel.
A.
It's beginning to seep into both of me lungs now. Consonant. Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
V.
please.
I'm beginning to hallucinate.
Exclamation mark.
Enough of that now. I feel like I've just sucked off either the engine.
Again. Sean Bean, everyone. OK, the scores at the moment, Richard and Rob have no points. That's John right. and Claudia have 31 points.
That's right.
And here's your teaser. The words are dire nips. The clue is that's given me an idea. That's dire nips. That's given me an idea. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were dire nips. The clue was that's given me an idea. It was, of course, inspired. OK, on with the game. Richard and Rob, you get to choose the letters.
Can we have four C's? And then,
C.
Yep.
V.
I thought you were specifying letters for a moment then.
M.
Yeah, four C's.
Oh!
OK.
Yeah, sure.
This is not Roman times.
All the vowels.
All vowels.
E. I.
Yeah! Shall we have some, we'll go C's now, because we've got enough V's, haven't we?
G.
Can we have another C, please?
Another C? N.
OK, and your time starts now.
Ah, this is so annoying. Just... Ah, the bloody clock keeps going. So off-putting.
You've got 15 seconds left.
I can't concentrate with this clock going.
You must try.
Can't. Why couldn't you do it silently? You can't do an exam like this. It's really weird. And that flourish is not helping. I mean, from that point, if you can think at that point where it's going da-da-da-da-da, I mean, that should be after the 30 seconds.
If you found the clock annoying, how do you think I felt? You spoke the whole way through that.
I didn't even write. All I did was I wrote it down and then I got upset. I'll say what I got now.
What did you get?
I got nothing, Jimmy.
Rob, how many?
Five.
Five? OK. Claudia, what have you got?
I've got seven.
Seven. OK, and John?
Well, if Claudia's got a seven, I'll say four.
No! What have you got?
Someone had to declare a four there, didn't they? I mean, Jesus, let's not ignore the thing. It's right there. Some of us don't see it that often.
OK, let's hear your four then, John.
Scent. I don't go to America very often.
Rob, you're five.
Given.
Claudia, you're seven.
Venting.
Excellent. Venting. Oh, an excellent from Susie. An excellent.
I went venting and then I realised it was the end.
7 points for Claudia. Sean Bean. Susie, could they have done any better?
We got seven. Venting.
Yeah.
As well.
So at the end of that, John and Claudia are in the lead with 38 points. Okay. On to another numbers round. OK, John and Claudia, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, eight numbers.
Six small. Just Whoa. To prove the power of the small man.
All the little ones up there.
Two. Five. Three. Two. Ten. And one.
One, ten, two, three, Ooh. Five, two.
Good luck, everyone.
Right.
OK, your time starts now.
Called a bit drop, y'all.
A big drop?
It's a bit drop.
Did you get it?
Yes.
Rob, did you
no,
get
I
it?
No, I got 24. I just added them all together.
OK, well, as long as you're having fun and you're indoors out of the way. OK, John, did you get it?
I don't think it can be done.
Claudia,
no.
Did you get it?
No. Not even close. I tried. I got okay, to so seven.
They don't think it could be done, but you think you definitely did it. OK, Richard.
Okay. Take the 10 and square it.
That's not allowed in Countdown.
Actually, can you cube it? Sorry.
Cube it. Okay. And then I'd like you to square the 5 for me, please.
I like it.
And then I'd like you to time tap 25 by the 2.
The other 2. Perfect.
Haven't and then take it
off.
Away, and you've got your 950.
Okay. Oh. So, Rachel, mind blown?
That was amazing. That was proper maths, and you haven't used any of the numbers twice.
Thank
you,
never
Rachel. Been done before. It's groundbreaking.
That's right.
You're my hero.
All of those things.
Could it actually be done?
No. No way. No.
It's just been done.
Well, despite Richard's amazing maths, no one got any points there. The scores at the moment, Richard and Rob have
no points.
No, what? They've got...
Hey,
come on.
Rachel.
Come on, mate. What?
I'm not even on their team, but he just did something wizard.
If you want to square and cube things, get a job in a fucking jelly factory, mate.
maybe the weakest comeback there's ever been. Get a job in a jelly factory, mate. That's the worst thing that's ever been said. OK, the scores at the moment, Richard and Rob have no points, John and Claudia have 38. OK, time to go across once more to Dictionary Corner. Sean Bean, what have you got for us?
I was about to show you how to cut a wild animal using only your bare hands.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, why not? All right, well, I'll need a boar, a wild boar, or next best thing. So, Beckett, front and centre. Let's go. Come on, friend. Let's do this.
What's happening here, mate?
Right. Join me on stage, but get on all fours for me and face that way.
I'm not sure about this, Sean.
So, face him on fours. Now, a big beast like this, Jimmy's going to give you, what, 50, 60 pounds of meat? Good meat, too. None of that streaky shit. Now, on your back, pig.
Pig.
One thing you're going to have to bear in mind is before you get to the carving, you're going to want to wash it and drain it first. And best position for that is up high, ankles up, that's it. Jesus Christ, what a pig. Bend at the hip. Bend at the hip.
I can't, that's how I go.
You've got no
bend, mate. That's all I've got.
Well, Lord Ayoade, were I to make an incision on this beast to get the finest cut, where would you recommend I slice first?
The hip, ideally for you.
Maybe the head?
Maybe the head. Well, that's going to make an awkward position even more awkward.
I didn't like this at the beginning, but I'm getting quite into it.
You just want to get a nice, good cut. Oh, I can't even get closer. You are
slide
rigid,
down.
My friend.
Just slide down.
Slide down.
Slide down. Come here.
Oh, hello. That's
oh, you found a bit of bend now, haven't you?
He's got it now. To get the... No, you're going to have to release me there.
I don't feel that vulnerable anymore.
Sure. Oh, my God.
Introduce a digit.
Both as we
It is Countdown. I mean, it's not a crazy suggestion. Yeah.
I like you, Beckett Bull. Our conversation, it flows like warm butter off a Spaniard's back. You can consider yourself a fan.
Sean Bean, everyone. Sean Bean. OK, the scores at the moment, Richard and Rob have still got nothing. John and Claudia have 38 points. And here's your final teaser. The words are paid slut. The clue is they've earned it. That's paid slut. They've earned it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were paid slut. The clue was they've earned it. It was, of course, plaudits. OK, time for our final letters game. John and Claudia, your turn to choose the letters.
Please.
All right. OK, consonant, please. Thanks, Claude. And then two vowels.
M.
Yes. Two vowels, E and A.
And then consonant, please.
S.
Yeah, more of those.
More of them. R.
Yes.
Same.
L.
And now vowels.
T. And then O.
And
thank
E.
You. Thank you.
OK, your time starts now. Claudia, how many did you get?
Seven.
John, how many?
I try an eight, but I think I've made it up.
An eight? You may have made it up. OK, excellent. Rob?
Eight. Definitely not made up.
OK. Richard?
I've got a hard three.
OK, well, let's hear your three.
I got toe.
You got toe, and really just at the last minute there.
Yeah, I couldn't see a way to lengthen it either. I just got...
Got the S.
Yeah. Oh.
There is an S. Claudia, you're seven.
Out of those, Stormer.
Stormer.
I'm not sure it's a word. You see, what happens is when I hear the clock, I just instantly try and look for more stuff. That's good, yes, that's the one that I
meant. The Latin spelling of Stormer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
OK, so that's not there. Rob, what's your eight?
You want my eight?
Yeah, I want your eight.
Malteser.
Malteser, as in a guy from...
A guy from Malta, Little Round Chocolate, whatever you want.
Susie, would that be in there in any capacity?
So inspired, but it's not in, and it would have capital M anyway.
John, what is your eight?
I don't think this is a thing. Mole rats.
Mole rats are a thing. I see that we take the kids to the zoo. It's a naked mole rat, and it's in the nighttime world.
Susie, is it in our world or just the nighttime world?
Well, there is such a thing as a mole rat, but it's two words.
Oh.
Oh. It's just up your street, John, because it's herbivorous and short-legged.
So... So the points there go to Richard Iwadi for toe. 3 points. Sean Bean, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
Finish them, Susie.
Well, there was a nine there.
Yeah, come on, Susie, finish us off.
I've always wanted somebody to say that to me. Yeah. There was a nine.
Susie.
Yeah. This is the opposite of Rob's legs. It's elastomer, which is a natural substance that has elastic properties.
Oh, wow, well done, Susie Dent, and Sean Bean. OK, so Richard and Rob have 3 points. John and Claudia are just in the lead with 38. OK, fingers on buzzers. It's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Time starts now.
Untwisted.
Let's have a look. He's only gone and bloody done it. So the final scores are Richard and Rob have 3 points, but tonight's winners with 48 points, John and Claudia. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Foot Spa. Jump in. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Gemma Chan, the star of Humans, explores the current frontiers of artificial intelligence in How to Build a Human next Saturday at 9. Then Series 2 of Humans begins next Sunday at 9. And you can even get yourself up to speed and catch up on the whole of Series 1 on all four. Next tonight, F1 qualifying highlights.